step back into it. Some people, they live those characters 24/7 for months.
Oh, wow.
And kudos to them.
Or not. I mean, many of those people, they end up killing themselves.
Yeah, and so when you're carrying around that character for so many months, it's not as easy as just, you know, relaxing music, showering, and...
The video is about to start. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. There we go!
How many times we watch a movie in TV or in the movie theater and we see these actors and then we wonder, I wonder how are their lives? How do they do this? Is it easy? Is it worth it? How much money do they make, etc.? So, you know what? I couldn't hold it anymore. So I grabbed one actor, I brought him here, and I asked them so many questions. Watch the video. This is your co-host, Burbujita. Say hi, Burbujita. Hi, everyone. Hi people, I'm super excited because here we are with our two times Emmy winning Vincent De Paul.
Hey, how are you? Good to
how
see
are
everyone.
You, Vincent?
Things are great, Gustavo. I'm so happy to be here in South Florida and at your amazing, amazing salon.
Well, great. Vincent, the reason why we're doing this interview is because how many times we would like to grab somebody by the neck, like an actor like yourself, mm-hmm. and ask them so many questions. Some of them will be easy for you to answer, some might not be, but sure. I mean, you'll do it with grace. So first of all, what make you, you know, just for you to know people, I know Vincent for a couple of years. So how many years ago is this? Like 20? I mean,
it's more than a decade plus. So when
more
I first
than two
came,
decades plus.
Yeah, when I first came to South Florida, I had been here since I think 93, 94. So it's whatever after the 90s.
I think in 97. I was in kindergarten and he was in elementary.
Yeah,
so.
Right. Yeah, it's been a long time.
Yeah.
But I've seen your progression, of course, all the outstanding work you do, Angels and helping those different organizations. Plus, I've seen you shepherd along a lot of other projects that you've worked on, and also your great salon that is
spectacular. Thank you, Vincent.
It's very good.
Yeah, this is all about you today.
Thank you. Very kind.
What's the bike for?
You'll see.
So, I met you when we used to go together to the Versace. I mean, probably Lino Mansion and all those years where whatever.
The Casa Casarina, Johnny Versace days. Yeah.
Right. I remember that like if it was yesterday and whatever. So then you were like this muscle buff model, like sex icon. I don't even know how to call you. Yes, you were, and you know it.
No, I am.
You still are, actually.
Thank you. I did a lot of work at that time because South Florida was destination for a lot of the fitness magazines and swimwear. So
I love fitness.
when you know, basically, when it's freezing cold in New York City, everywhere else, in December, January, they said, let's bring a crew down to South Beach to shoot swimwear.
Yes.
Let's shoot all the exercise workouts in South Beach because it was great lighting, good weather, and a tropical kind of background. And that's why it was selected. So I did that work.
You did a lot of work. I remember you were all over the magazines. I mean, like, you did so much. Like, I remember in South Beach, it was everybody, they still know you, but in those years, it was like, oh my God, Vincent, whatever.
It was fun. There was a great energy then in South Beach, and everyone knew everyone, and models and actors and photographers and stylists and everyone. We were just one big family.
Yeah. So now, in those years, did you ever think that you wanted to be an actor, or you would have been just happy ever after just being a model?
Absolutely. I know that there were a few questions, you know, what was the inspiration for film and TV, and was I, when I'm modeling, thinking about doing film and TV? 100%.
Okay.
It was always that transition from just doing still print work and move into film and TV. It was always been my desire to do more than just, you know, I always say a glorified coat hanger, because you could either put the clothing on a mannequin or on a hanger and photograph it, or you could put it on a live person and you all of a sudden bring that fashion, that style, that energy, that editorial look to life. So I liked it, but I always wanted to do
more
film and TV and more. So,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, great.
This card to you.
So this would be that question, right? What are your inspirations in the film and TV world?
Yeah, I get inspired by so many things. One, I get inspired by working with great emerging directors. I get inspired by great scripts that are unique and things that I've never have read before in any kind of novel or any other kind of, you know, magazines. A lot of times some movies are based on a magazine article or a New York bestseller. If I haven't read it and I'm compelled to the content, I'm really happy about it. That's what inspires me to do unique work and great work.
Okay, sounds good. Can you tell me some of the directors that you have worked during your career?
Absolutely. Some of the directors that I always find will always be in my mind are like directors like Penny Marshall.
Was she like Laverne and Shirley?
Yeah, she was the original Laverne and Shirley. So she was Laverne DeFazio and Shirley Feeney on the Laverne and Shirley show, which was a spinoff of Happy Days.
I know, oh my God.
And so she directed me in Riding Cars with Boys with the late Brittany Murphy and Steve Zahn and Drew Barrymore. And so she was such a great director. I mean, she, you know, communicated with each one of her actors so well. You know, she of course would love watching basketball and eating potato chips on set, but then she would take time and really focus on us and really walk us through the journey of the characters. And I played a football player in the 1960s. And so, you know, there was a scene where, you know, we had to make Drew Barrymore cry in a scene and she wasn't getting it. And, you know, so the director took me to the side and said, okay, these are the kind of things that I think would work. Try to do this. And so we did the scene and Drew was so appreciative of it because she, at that point, she was thankful that, you know, she had those moments with the other actors to inspire her to be that role. And so it was just really great. So she was great. Working with Barry Levinson, Academy Award winner Barry Levinson of the movie Rain Man. Mm. I did a movie with him called What's Happening? I think it's called What's Happening. Yeah, I think it was with Bobby De Niro. And Barry Levinson was great. And I like working with him because he's also from Maryland, from Baltimore, Maryland, where I'm from. Great director. Gosh, the list goes on. I worked with the director for 7 years, solid, Gregory J. Martin, Emmy Award-winning director from the series The Bay, which is on Amazon Prime. And he gives the actors a lot of insight onto his characters as well. And he's always, you know, available to talk through the characters, because when you do a soap or a web series or a series, there's a journey of your character from, you know, the first year until the seventh year, and you always are learning more and more about the dimensions of who they are and, you know, their joys and their plight, their sorrows and their happiness. And so he's always available to let us know about those ideas he has for your character. I play Father Leone on The Bay, the series on Amazon Prime. So yeah, so many directors. I mean, my career spans from 1987 to present. So there's John Waters from Hairspray. They're a great director. Matthew Porterfield, who I recently worked with on a movie called Siler's Point. Christian Filippella, the movie Silver Case, Brian Skiba, all the holiday movies. So yeah, the list goes on. There's a lot of directors and they all give you unique tools to be the best you possibly can be.
Just me and this beautiful sunshiny day.
Which are the movies that, you know, that you feel most proud of, that you have made or that you have appeared in?
Every time I do a movie or
I know you're
every time I get inspired by, like, the movie is finished and it's out there in the world and it's widely released. So there's no one film, they're just the entire collection of my films. Every time I get to see that the movie is being celebrated or enjoyed by audiences, that makes me happy.
Great, and yet, which ones are the ones that you would recommend people to watch? For example, okay, you cannot miss this one from me.
Okay, like, the movies that I love and they put you in a good mood, especially now during the pandemic and everyone's quarantining, is go to uptv.com, that's uptv.com, it's free. You can get the app or get it on your TV, and you can watch Beverly Hills Christmas and This
Is Our
Christmas.
Oh my God, that's my favorite, I love that.
And they're really fun, they have a little doggy in it, a little Pomeranian, Jack the Pomeranian, and they're really fun, you know, films. I love family content. The films Bernie the Dolphin 1 and 2, and then I'm very, very happy to do a series also for PureFlix called The Encounter Season 2. The Encounter Season 2, Episode 7 called Homeward Bound, where I play Neil Jobson. And it's based on the Book of Job, and he's given all of these different challenges in his life and how he overcomes the challenges. So The Encounter Season 2 on PureFlix.com.
Wow. Well, let's check that one out.
Thanks, you should go visit her.
Well, never mind about that.
We have to say this because if it wasn't for them, we couldn't do what we do. This video is brought to you by Gustavo Brand Studio, where hair for ladies and gentlemen becomes high art, located in the heart of Miami Beach, Florida, and Sultry Eyes Lash Studio, dedicated to bring out the goddess out of every woman, now located inside Gustavo Brand Studio. The Brand siblings, doing their best work together. If you're in the area of Miami Beach, please check the website, book your appointment. The website is here below, and let's get this started. And South Beach Charity Angels. South Beach Charity Angels is our own charity, and it operates here in Miami, Florida. If you want to know more, read the website. Thank you very much for watching. And then this question has two questions. So it says, what do you use for you to get into a character role? And then the same question has another question, which is, okay, so once you get there, you're gonna tell us how you get, once you get there, when you go home, let's say you put all the clothes away and then you're like driving back home. I mean, is it difficult for you to get out of character, or do you still keep it in?
It's very, very interesting, and I try to. It's almost like therapy. Your character goes through a journey. It's internalized and then externally it comes out. But it's all around you. It's in the fiber of who you are. It's in the DNA of who you are. What I try to do to get into the character is that I read the script. I try to do research on, you know, time, place, education, socioeconomic background, life struggles. I try to create this entire list about this character, and I do a character study of the character. And so I learn about, you know, what was his life challenges, as if he had life challenges when he was a child. As a child, he was adopted, or as a child, he never got to know who his parents were. It's not the experience that I had, because, you know, I knew my parents. I'm one of 8 children. I knew my 7 brothers and sisters. But this character may not have had that. And so you go and you read about individuals who, you know, were adopted at a young age and how their life was and the great epiphanies they had, the great celebrations they had. So I go through all these different things. So I have like a chart about who this person is. And then with the words, the written words of the author, I kind of break down, you know, the intonation of their voices, the tonal quality of their voices, and I do that. But I always try to go from a place of truth. Now, some of the characters that I play, like in The Welder, he's a very dark scientist who, you know, he tries to end the plight of racial discrimination, and he goes about it in a very unique way. When I did this role, it was a very different role and who he was. And when I would rap every day on set, you know, it took me time, you know, when I got home and I showered, that entire process of showering and kind of shedding that character really helped me. And then I would come out of the shower, put on the robe, and then I would kind of drink tea and like be very in a relaxed mindset, so my mind and my body could release the character from its being. So that's what I try to do. Everyone has different ways to do it. But if I just keep on carrying all of those characters with me for the last 20 years, it would
you
just
will
weigh,
be a little bit crazier yeah, than you it, really are
it would,
now.
Yeah, absolutely. It would weigh you down. So yeah. You try to shed them off.
Yeah.
And then step back into it. Some people, they live those characters 24/7 for months.
Oh, wow.
And kudos to them.
Or not. I mean, many of those people, they end up killing themselves.
Yeah, and you so know. When you're carrying around that character for so many months, it's not as easy as just, you know, relaxing music, showering, and, you know,
bye-bye.
Chilling to shed that character from yourself. So that's what I do.
I see it almost as a possession. Like, if you allow a possession to come into your body, and then this possession manipulates you to leave through you something, and then you have to get rid of it.
That's true, very, very true.
We have to believe that everything will be okay.
For all the inspiring emerging actors, forge ahead, surround yourself with like-minded people, surround yourself with other fellow artists, actors, cinematographers, writers, directors, because they will only inspire you to be the best you possibly can be.
Would you recommend this actor career for people? Because I know it's not easy, let's be honest. It's not like you, even if, you know, a girl could be the most beautiful, a guy could look like you, be the most beautiful. It doesn't matter, but like, would you recommend, because it's a big no. It's a big like, you know, like no all the time until they get you. I mean, it's just like, I cannot even imagine. Would you recommend this to people? And once, if you do, then what's your advice for these people?
Oh, certainly. So, a few things, one of which is that if you're really inspired to do this, it's, of course, you have to understand that this is not a one-off. It's
a
cumulative. It's not just, oh, today I'm going to be an actor and, you know, I'm
going
to try for the weekend.
Here I go, I'm an Oscar winner. Okay, got it.
It's an accumulative work. So maybe your first 3 years you work, and then the next 3 years you don't, and then the next 3 years you do. So it's everything is a cumulative, and you remember the different skill sets that you've had through your life, and you try to recall those. So when they're needed, you do that. And I do recommend people to really think if they're going to choose this career, that why they're choosing it. Not because of the fame or the fortune, but because you do want to create content for the world that may some way give someone an epiphany in the Midwest where they're struggling with some life struggle, and you play a character that they related to, and then they're able to get through their struggle.
You need to go. I have somewhere to be.
I know.
You know, when I do people's hair and whatever, and we talk about, we gossip, and we're like, how do you think they got that role? I mean, especially for the girls out there. I don't think it happens so much for guys. Maybe I'm wrong. You will tell me. But since, is it true that a lot of people, they request, I hate to say this, but to sleep with the actors?
Yeah, so recently, Ryan Murphy and Mr. Falchuk did a series called Hollywood, which was based on the memoirs of Scotty Bowers, a full service, the book.
And full service.
Yeah, so it was a gas station in Hollywood where emerging actors would work as gas attendants, and they would share sexual favors afterwards in like this room in the back, and they were invited to different events and George Cukor and all these different things that they, some of the stuff is based completely on fiction. Some of it is based on some fact, but it does exist in the industry, you know, and it existed then, it existed now, but I think that you have to make those life choices for yourself and be true to thyself be true. Meaning that if you feel confident enough that you don't have to do that, and that you have enough ability, then you have to figure out a way to continue doing what you can do with your ability. That should be how you are motivated, not by anything else. And you know, the entire Me Too movement is so relevant and so important, and we need to nurture and help everyone, and no one should be marginalized, and we should not marginalize anyone, and we should be respectful of everyone. If we do something wrong, we say we're sorry. And when we do something right, we should be commended, I feel. And that's my belief.
So, that's good.
Yeah.
This would be my last question, unless you want to ask something. So, for example, we're human beings, and when we're in set, sometimes we love people we're working with, sometimes the energies are not as pleasant, to not say like you might hate someone for no reason or whatever, or like when they get close to you, you're like, oh my God, I wish this person was not as close to me. So in those cases, or sometimes you might even fall in love with someone, how do you handle this, especially the bad energy? Like,
when there's bad energy on set, you try to say, okay, let me get through this and get through the day. You talk to your producers, you talk with the other folks and say, hey, this is what's happening. This is what I'm feeling. I want to know how we can partner together to get through this. So that's it. And every time I fall in love with every one of my co-stars, like that is my job, is to believably portray the character and find that love ship no matter what. Every one of my leading ladies, I fall in love with in each movie show, because that's what one needs to do to make it real, to make it true. And you find different elements of that person to fall in love with, and there's always something to fall in love with.
So. Okay, sounds great. So I got the answer that I needed. So basically, you just have to get professional and go through it until the end, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Like everybody shall.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Have you ever been in the position where, even though you tried to be professional, I know you're super professional, but you chose not to continue in the project because you're like, my inner peace is more important than this BS, you know?
I know a lot of people are relying on you, myself, or whoever else, and so I will always have inner peace, because at the core of who I am, I always am able to have inner peace. When I'm working in LA, I always say I detox from LA by coming to Miami. So I know that I have, you know, a safe place, let's say. And so I'll always have inner peace, I think, and I'll always be okay.
Okay, so. Great. Well, Vincent, this,
thank you,
you
Gustavo.
Know, this was so great.
It's my pleasure. I wish everyone the very best. And I thank you for having these great kind of shows so people can enjoy and take a little bit of a divertimento, like a diversion of, you know, everything else that's going on in the world and enjoy themselves.
Yeah, so I mean, under the comments here, you can keep asking stuff, and maybe I can, maybe Vincent will read the comments on YouTube.
Absolutely.
And send, if you have any questions, yes, and then he can answer more questions. But you know, I always wanted to have, like, I always ask him stuff. I always even ask him more stuff that is not appropriate for here, but anyway.
No, it's great. It's always great to talk about the industry.
Yeah. But
so Vincent De Paul 12, Vincent De Paul 21. Vincent De Paul 12 is Instagram, and Vincent De Paul 21 is Twitter.
Okay, we'll put them in the in the description of the video.
Yeah. And you can send me messages. But happy to be here at Gustavo Brand Hair Studio
in South Florida.
And everyone, take care no matter where you are in the world. Peace, happiness, and love.
Thank you, and don't miss our next video. Have a great time.
Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. That's clicking on the little bell. Comment all you want. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like.
Don't forget to subscribe to grow the community.
And also, don't forget to follow our social media. And if you want to go ahead and share this video in all your platforms, share the love. Till next time!
Bye.
Isn't it great that we can contribute to the arts with all these great Maryland artists, and that they could be celebrated all around the world?